Sony and AMD have given us a look at what likely is the next generation PlayStation hardware, and it's looking very, very impressive for the future of that platform. And we're going to talk all about that. But before we jump into that, guys, we're really close to 17,000 subscribers. If you guys could please do me a favor, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're not already, and share the video to help grow our community. I appreciate it a lot, and it really does go a long way. Now let's jump into this AMD and PlayStation partnership that seems to be super fruitful as far as what we're seeing so far. And this came as an official video drop from PlayStation's YouTube channel, where Mark Cerny and Jack Kuhn talked about this partnership with Project Amethyst. And we're going to talk about what it all means in layman's terms for the most part, as far as the future of the hardware goes and what we can expect. Now, we know they've been working together under something called Project Amethyst, which focuses on using machine learning to improve how games are rendered. They talked about this previously. This is nothing new as far as that goes, but we got an update on this partnership. So for the future, instead of relying purely on brute GPU power, they're building systems that think intelligently using AI to fill in details, enhance lighting, and smooth out gameplay. So it's going to really unload all that pressure off the GPU and allow us to get a lot of great results without all the brute force that is required and the GPU power that's required to attain those goals. And this is the evolution of PSSR and FSR. But the big reveal here is that those two actually share the same neural networks under the hood, meaning they are co-developing these AI models that are going to power these future pieces of hardware. And to make that AI even more efficient, they are introducing something new called neural arrays. Now, normally a GPU's compute units each work on tiny separate chunks of data. That's great for traditional graphics, but it's inefficient for AI workloads. Neural arrays change that. They let clusters of GPU cores work together, sharing data and processing big AI tasks as a team. So that means bigger machine learning models, faster upscaling, better denoising, and overall smarter rendering without a power penalty. Next is Radiance Cores, a completely new hardware block focused on ray tracing and path tracing. Basically, it's realistic lighting, super realistic lighting that you can expect with these updates. Right now, GPUs handle both the light simulation and the shading in the same units, which slows things down. Radiance Cores separate those tasks, giving lighting its own dedicated hardware, freeing the GPU to handle everything else. So this could finally make cinematic level lighting possible in real time on console hardware. Then there's universal compression, which tackles one of gaming's biggest problems. Modern GPUs can only move so much data between memory and the processor. The features like ray tracing or 4K textures eat that up fast. Universal compression expands on existing texture compression and applies it to all data going in and out of memory. That means more detail, higher frame rates, lower power usage, and more efficient rendering overall. So all of these technologies, neural arrays, Radiance Cores, and universal compression are designed to work together. The AI systems process visuals smarter, Radiance Cores handle lighting more efficiently, and universal compression keeps the whole thing running smoothly. And the end result will be that games look sharper, run faster, and feel more lifelike than anything we've seen before without just brute forcing power. They are still early though, and they only really exist in simulation at the moment, but it's what we can expect from the future hardware. So the next PlayStation console won't just be a stronger console, it's going to be a smarter console, one that's driven by AI, which is going to help us get much better results without having to put as much effort forward as far as power on the GPU and everything else. So this is very exciting for PlayStation's platform, right? In a time where we're hearing about Xbox having as many issues as they are, people talking about the industry as far as console gaming goes, dying, and you know, even talks about Xbox not even making future hardware as far as the rumor mill goes, we've got PlayStation over here dropping big news about future hardware in partnership with AMD and some incredible tech that they're going to have that is really going to take PlayStation to the next level. So PS6 is looking pretty special, and I think that we're going to be very impressed with the end results. The one thing that might be a little challenge is displaying this to the people, right? As far as what we saw with the PS5 Pro, it was kind of hard to relay that info on a YouTube video. It's more of a situation where you can only see the big differences when you're playing on the system yourself in person and not so much on videos. So I think PS6 is going to be pretty awesome, and I think that it's going to deliver a lot of greatness, and I think that I personally will be enjoying the next generation console whenever it does come, which Mark Cerny seems to allude to it being in 2028, which again gives us more time as we've got 2026, 27, and then 28 after that. So we've got another few years left in this life cycle, which looks very promising as far as getting our value in these consoles. Personally speaking, I've really enjoyed the PS5 generation. I've really enjoyed my PS5 Pro, and I look forward to the future of the console and the platform in hopes that it's a very bright future, one filled with a lot of great games and fantastic hardware. But I'd love to hear you guys' thoughts on this topic. Let me know what you're feeling as far as the PlayStation 6 goes and this partnership that they have with Project Amethyst. Do you think it's going to be an exciting project in the end? Do you think it's going to be something that you look forward to? Are you still happy with your PS5 and not looking forward to an upgrade in 2028? As always, if you enjoyed the video, hit that like button. Subscribe. If you're new to the channel, guys, we're on our way to 17,000 subs. We're very close. Really would appreciate it if you guys help us get there. And share the video to help grow our community. It really makes a big difference. And I'll talk to you guys on the next one. Take care.